is the meeting of the Passaic County Board of Chosen Commissioners. Well, it's not really chosen commissioners, county commissioners. It's June 14th. Started at 5:30 p.m. Roll call, please. Lou?
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Here.
Best.
Here.
Duffy.
Here.
Gallo.
Here.
Lepore.
Here.
Deputy Director Lazar. Director James.
Here.
Can I have the announcement of the open public meeting law, please?
Ladies and gentlemen, the notice requirement of the open public meetings law has been satisfied with respect to this meeting specifying the time, date, and location, including the annual notice adopted at the reorganization meeting and filed with the county clerk, posted in the administration building and mailed to two newspapers in accordance with the provisions of the law.
Thank you. I'm going to ask everybody to stand for the invocation, the Pledge of Allegiance, and after the Pledge of Allegiance, we're going to have a moment of silence to remember all the men and women who have died while in service to the United States Armed Forces, and all those who have died from COVID in Passaic County, especially the 201,404 residents who succumbed to it. We're also asking you for a moment of silence for Mr. Bob Jacobs, who was the Executive Director for Catholic Charities, and Bunny Kukin, the ancestor of the founders and the owners of the Botto House.
O God, who provides for thy people by thy power and rules over them in love, be gracious enough to bless thy servants, our county commissioners in this county of Passaic, that thy people may dwell in peace and safety through our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. I have a motion for the approval of the minutes from May 24th, 2022.
So be it. Second.
Duffy, seconded by Commissioner Lepore. Roll.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. Can I have approval of proclamations, please?
I'll move it.
Second.
Moved by Fielder Lepore and seconded by Fielder Best. Commissioner Best. Roll.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Poor.
Yes.
Deputy Director, Director James.
Yes. So here's a quarter for our county administrator, because I said freeholder, and that still applies. So there goes a quarter. It's now
right.
$75,000 I paid him by saying freeholder. Anyway, administrator's report. I'm going to turn the show over to our county administrator, Anthony DeNova.
Director, thank you so much. We are honored to have with us this evening the executive director of the New Jersey Association of Counties. For those who don't know, that is the lobbying arm of counties throughout the state of New Jersey. John Donatio is a dear friend of Passaic County, does a great job on behalf of all the counties throughout the state, lobbying Trenton for legislation that benefits not only our counties, our taxpayers, and the people that reside throughout the state of New Jersey. Each year, the New Jersey Association of County Foundation offers three scholarships. The generosity of Investors Bank, Amazon, who is new this year, and SHI. So I'm going to ask John to come to the podium. We have three students here in the audience. We're going to ask them to come forward as well. The students, the recipients, why don't you come forward? John is going to talk a little bit about how each one of these students were awarded the scholarships.
Great, thank you, Mr. DeNova.
You're
appreciate
welcome,
it.
Mr. Donatio.
And it's great to see you, and thank you for giving the association a minute here today. And although we're the lobbying arm of county government, New Jersey, this is my favorite thing to do because I'm giving away other people's money. In fact, over the past 10 years, the NJAC Foundation, through the generosity, and Mr. DeNova mentioned some of the companies, Investors Bank, SHI, and Amazon, we've given away over $500,000 to over 750 county vocational technical school graduates who are continuing their education right here in the state of New Jersey. And I can tell you that the resumes of the students just get better and better every year, and we've had some terrific candidates this year. But I do want to, if we can, give Investors Bank, SHI, and Amazon a big round of applause for $50,000 that we're giving away this year. So thank you. So I got to put my glasses on because I'm old and blind. But we've got some terrific candidates this year, and the first we're going to talk about is the Investors Bank Scholarship, which is a $500 scholarship. So this is for Brett Dees, and Brett is an extraordinary young man who takes full advantage of opportunities to grow as a future professional. He is self-determined and pushes himself to do well in class in order to reach his goals. Brett would describe himself as hardworking, dependable, ambitious, and creative. The most important of these adjectives for Brett is being hardworking, because he knows he has great ethic and always wants to live up to his potential. So Brett is studying at Montclair State University, yeah. So not too far. Are you going to live there? All right, that's awesome. Yeah. That's even better. You can save your mom and dad some money by staying home. And you're going to study graphics design.
Yeah.
So that's congratulations. So, Mr. D, would you like to do one at a time?
Commissioners?
Okay. All right, so I'll tell you what. So I'm going to present this to you first, and then we'll take a picture. So congratulations. Do you want to say anything, or now you're good? You can say something. Right. And by the way, Investors Bank has been a fantastic corporate citizen. They've given us, the Inject Foundation, over $200,000 over the past 10 years. So we really appreciate their generosity, along with SHI International, which has awarded the Inject Foundation grants of up to $50,000 over the past 3 or 4 years. And our recipient of the SHI International Scholarship Award is Josh Marquez, who is graduating from the Passaic County Technical Institute. Josh will be attending NJIT. Great job, Josh. Majoring in computer science with $14,000 in direct net costs for tuition. I believe that he's deserving of the scholarship because he's willing to put in the extra work to succeed in his collegiate studies. You're going to study computer science, which was one of the requirements of the SHI degree. So, Josh, congratulations to you. And again, another $500 scholarship from SHI International. Congratulations. Josh, you want to say a couple of words? No? All right. It's great. And then last but certainly not least, and this is one of our new grants this year, and this is from Amazon. And they are awarding students in all 21 counties a $475 scholarship. So Danielle Cespedes, did I say it?
Danelle.
Yeah. I got the last name right. All right, Danelle. Danelle Cespedes, who is going to NJIT. This is really cool. He's a first generation student that will be attending colleges. That's awesome. So first person in the family to attend college. Great job. Me too, by the way. So I love that. Danelle challenged himself with both honors and AP courses at the DCL STEM Academy. Although Danelle excelled in computer science, he will be pursuing civil engineering at NJIT. So fantastic, man. Congratulations to you, Danelle. How about you, Danelle? You want to break the pattern?
Yeah.
All right.
So first of all, I want to give big thanks to everyone that came here, and as well as the board members as well, for being here, and actually great honor. And also saying, like, this is, never knew actually this is kind of the first thing I've ever done this, been part of this, so I'm kind of nervous. So I just want to give thanks, and thank you for taking some time of your day to come here. I'm very grateful. Thank you.
Even more valuable than the scholar than the money that they received, there is a certificate from the commissioners congratulating each of you, which will put it on eBay, and I'm sure you could probably get a lot of money for that. But so we're going to take a group picture with the three boys and Mr. Donatio with the commissioners. If family members are here, if you want to come up and be part of the picture, we would love that too. Don't be shy.
Push this back towards here, and then we'll everybody get front of it. Everybody come on front of it.
Well, I'm not wearing a suit because after this hat, I'm going to put down 2,200.
What's up, Tom?
John Donato is a very good friend. He says to me, you know, you can get in here. I said, no, don't worry. We crop you out anyway.
Lou, your job is never done, Lou. Huh?
Mr. Donadio, thank you so much for being with us this evening, and congratulations again to the students. Best of luck in your collegiate career. Very proud of you. Director James, that concludes my portion of the administrative agenda.
Right, so we have a hearing on a guarantee ordinance, so I need a motion to open the public hearing on the guarantee ordinance 22-04.
I move it.
There a second?
Second.
Does anybody present wish to, desire to be, I'm sorry, a roll call?
County Commissioners Bartlett?
Yes.
Best?
Yes.
Duffy?
Yes.
Gallo?
Yes.
Lepore?
Yes.
Director James?
Yes. So this is on the guarantee ordinance 2204. Does anybody present desire to be heard on guarantee ordinance 2204 only for this particular open portion of the meeting?
Seeing no one at the, at the podium, I move to close the public portion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll. County Commissioners Bartlett?
Yes.
Best?
Yes.
Duffy?
Yes.
Gallo?
Yes.
Lepore?
Yes.
Director James?
Yes, and I want just, all right, so what I'm going to do right now, I am pulling, as is my privilege, I am pulling number five, the motion to adopt the guarantee ordinance 2204, and I'm also pulling off the consent agenda L1, the resolution from the Board of County Commissioners. So that's not, doesn't require a vote. They are no longer on the agenda, and we will revisit at some point in the future. So,
number five was?
Number five is where I'm tabling, not tabling, I'm pulling today.
I got it.
And I'm pulling the first L1 of the administration and finance on the consent agenda.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Thank you.
So, can we move? All right. So we're at commission reports. You know that we have on, I'm pleased to announce that we have on our consent agenda tonight number 8, which is designating Juneteenth as a holiday in the County of Passaic in recognition of African American freedom and the abolition of slavery in the United States of America, and it's pursuant to NJSA 40:20-1. It is a state holiday. We are going to match that state holiday, so third Friday of every June from here on in will be a holiday in lockstep with the state of New Jersey, and is also a holiday, not that particular day, but it's also a holiday for the federal government. Jersey actually preceded the federal government in voting for this to be a holiday. It's a very important holiday for American history. So we are all proud to be doing this and making sure that we remember that date forever. So we will get to that when we get to R8. That's my report for today, because I think that's the most important thing I have to say. And the next one would be Sandy Lazara, who is away for, she will be back the next meeting. Commissioner Bartlett.
Thank you, Director, and I agree with you. I'm pleased that we're recognizing Juneteenth, and it's an important recognition, particularly for the African-American community here in Passaic County. I'm pleased to report that earlier this month, it was announced that Passaic County will be receiving a little over $1.9 million in federal Safe Routes to School funding. That determination was made by the New Jersey Department of Transportation. And altogether, we're going to have four grants that are going to protect school children, folks who walk to schools. And really, having been, you know, in and near so many of those schools, all the pedestrians, all the bikers in those neighborhoods are going to be benefiting from these grants. Patterson's going to receive $662,000, which is going to enable them to create safety improvements at 86 different intersections serving 15 schools. That's things like flashing stop signs, school zone ahead signs, those flashing pedestrian-activated crosswalk warning signs to help reduce the incidence of pedestrian accidents, pedestrian fatalities, particularly when it comes to our school children. In Clifton, $568,000 in federal funds are going to provide for safety and disability improvements to the underground pedestrian tunnel under Route 46 and Piaget Avenue near the intersection of Day Street. That's going to make it a safer place, a place where kids with disabilities, kids on bikes, et cetera, are able to use that pedestrian underpass to access Christopher Columbus Middle School and PS3 instead of crossing Route 46 on the surface of the road. Little Falls is getting $248,000 for improvements to sidewalks, pedestrian safety barriers, and safety signals along Wilmore Road, serving PS1 and PS2. And in the city of Passaic, $425,000 will enable the construction and installation of detectable warning surfaces, crosswalk symbols and striping, pedestrian warning signage, and ADA-compliant sidewalks serving Theodore Roosevelt School, Memorial Elementary School, Sally D. Gamble School number 16, and Yeshiva Katana of Passaic. All of that is made possible not out of your property tax dollar, but out of those new federal funds that we're able to pull in thanks to competitive grants, and I want to thank the New Jersey Department of Transportation and our colleagues across the region at NJTPA for supporting those federal programs. And that's my report.
Thanks, Black Father. Appreciate that. So to go along with our vote here around Juneteenth, this mic is loud. To go along with the vote on Juneteenth, I wanted to invite everyone to our second annual Passaic County Juneteenth celebration. It's going to take place this Saturday at the Pat Deany Boathouse at Garrett Mountain from the hours of 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. There is a parade, annual parade that takes place in Patterson that's starting off at 10 a.m. from the Masonic Temple to Eastside Park. Instead of having a festival at Eastside Park as they normally do, we've decided this year to do a countywide festival at Garrett Mountain. So I want to thank everyone who helped put it together, especially Kelly. Kelly, thank you so much for spearheading this. It'll be live music, food, kids zone. It's going to be a great time. Games, I think Bruce said he's going to double dutch. I think that's what it was. He's going to be in a double dutch contest. All right. Yeah, we're stuff for sure. So again, everyone, please come out and celebrate Freedom Day. In addition to that, I also wanted to give a shout out to PCTI golf team who won the county golf tournament, which was hosted at our county golf course. Yes. You could tell they had a home court advantage there. It's a beautiful course. Everyone had great things to say about it. I had a chance to go up there and talk to all of the coaches from all of the schools in the county who were very excited and happy about all of the improvements at the golf course. So to our team
who's responsible, our Parks Department. You guys are doing an amazing job. Thank you so much. It's really appreciated by not just our county residents who play up there, but also our kids, too. Our kids really appreciate it. And then lastly, June, obviously, end of school year, wanted to congratulate all of our graduates throughout the county of Passaic. Yesterday, we had Passaic County Community College's graduation where our county county commissioner director had a chance to speak and send our graduates off. Also, in the next couple of weeks, obviously, PCTI, which is going to graduate the largest graduating class that they've ever graduated, including the first graduating class for the Diane Labosco STEM Academy. So that's going to be really exciting coming up on the 21st, is that?
24th for PCTI.
All right, and John would know because he think he has a graduate there. All right, congratulations. Congratulations again to everyone, and have a great afternoon. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I just have a couple of things on the agenda, as everyone's aware of. one of them is authorizing the purchase of active shooting training classes by the Office of Emergency Management. That's probably the most important thing that we have, other than how sad it is that we have active shooting and the things that go on in this country. And then we have authorizing a payment for the second year of contract with Angel Sense Incorporated for GPS tracking for autistic, elderly, and medical needs citizens, which is most important as well. I might need one soon, so Director, if you don't mind, right? Yeah, all right. Other than that, I wish everyone a very healthy and safe summer. Thank you.
Yes, I want to say one thing. We're going to allocate 100 bulletproof vests to the Dominican National Police.
Not to interrupt you through the director, that's been pulled.
Oh, it has been?
Yeah, we're just going to revisit that.
Oh, I apologize.
Yeah.
But at any rate.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Director. I have 10 resolutions on the consent agenda for my colleagues' review, and I ask for their support on it. I also would like to acknowledge that today we retired Baron, one of the sheriff's forces. After 21 years of service, we were able to actually, John DeCanto from Patterson arranged horse to spend the rest of its day at a great, great facility up in Wantage. As soon as the horse came out, Baron came out of the trailer. It started eating, and then it took off, checking out its new digs. There were three little short donkeys there that all of a sudden they became friends. But it was a great day for the retiring officer, and the horse is a sheriff's officer, has that designation. We usually provide it for canines, but it's the first time we retired a horse here in Passaic County. And very happy that we have a facility like that in Wantage that acts as a sanctuary for all these animals. And also, I also would like to congratulate all the graduates of all the schools in the area. Job well done, difficult time to be a student these days. So besides reading, writing, and arithmetic, they have to learn how to get by with all the nonsense going on today. So congratulations to them. And finally, I would like to wish the United States Army a happy 247th birthday. That's what I have.
It is Flag Day. You want to say that too?
I'm sorry?
It is Flag Day.
Oh, and today is Flag Day.
We saved that for, I'm
Director, I thought you were going to do it because you're taking down 2,000 flags tonight.
You're welcome to come help. We could use all the help that we can get.
If I can see them.
Mr. Director, I'm sorry. Can I?
Sure.
One more thing, I'm sorry. Also looking at our agenda, I wanted to make another plug for our parks, our county park system. We have on the agenda today item number 33, which is to advertise and receive bids for the Rifle Camp Amphitheater. Garrett Mountain gets a lot of the acclaim, but right next door you have Rifle Camp, which is just as beautiful. And we're finally looking to bring some life back by fixing up that amphitheater. Really excited about that. And also this summer for all of our hot kids out there, Camp Hope is opening up community swimming at our swimming pool. We're going to have an official opening on June 25th, where we'll open up the pool to the community, and it'll continue to be open throughout the year. Also, there'll be fun activities for kids to enjoy as well. So just want to make a plug for that.
I just want to point out to our sheriff's officer that the pool is only 2 feet deep, so, you know.
What's he, about 8 foot?
He's 8 foot, yeah. Mm. 8 foot. All right. Can I? There's no communications, apparently. And can I have somebody move the opening of the oral portion of the meeting? Public portion?
I'll move it.
Second?
Second.
Roll.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. This is the time for public comment. Is there anybody in the audience who would like to address the Board of County Commissioners? You'll have 3 minutes. Step to the podium, state your name and address, and you'll have 3 minutes to address us. Anyone?
Seeing no one at the podium, I move to close the public portion.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Roll.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. All right, so I need to know if anybody objects to anything from L2 to L57. Anyone?
I would like to vote separately on L7, please.
L7? I'm sorry, Commissioner, it was L7 and anything else?
No, that's it.
Okay. So I need a motion to approve on the consent agenda, L2 through 6 and L8 through 57.
I'll move it.
Second.
Roll.
Lepore and
Duffy. Yes.
Count. County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. I have a motion on L7.
I'll move it.
There's a second.
Second.
Roll call.
It was seconded by Best.
Yes. Roll call.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Abstain.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
It's EMTs there, so I'm very happy that the fire department comes, they send EMTs. So when I have the heart attack, taking down flags, there's somebody here to help. So, new business. Can I have a motion on the personnel agenda?
I'll move that.
For a second?
Oh. Say second. Second.
Roll.
Thank you.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. Got a motion on the bills list, please.
Move it.
Second.
Roll.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. So before we adjourn, I do kid around, but it's really important to get people to help put up the flags and take down the flags. I do that the times of the year that we do it, which is, I think, 6 times, because you actually feel like you're doing something. You know, these are family flags that are bought by people. We, the county commissioners, paid to put the killed in action flags who had no family so that section is complete. because they never would have had a flag, that we knew the names of the people who did die defending the country. So you're welcome to come. It's six times a year tonight. They're going to be there at 6, and we'll stay there until the flags are down. The fire department usually comes and helps. Sometimes they can't, and then we're just there longer. And the mornings, we're always there by 6 when the days that we do it. The next time will be the 4th of July. But you're welcome to come. It's quite a sight. And if you don't come, the next time we put them up will be the 4th of July. Try to drive through that day and take a look at what, you know, that's one of our parks. Clifton City Hall Clifton's very fortunate to have a grounds for the City Hall that's like a park. So drive through once. It's quite the show to see all those flags up. So anyway, I have a motion for adjournment.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Roll.
County Commissioners Bartlett.
Yes.
Best.
Yes.
Duffy.
Yes.
Gallo.
Yes.
Lepore.
Yes.
Director James.
Yes. Thank you all. You can sit there in a couple of weeks and we'll have this again, or you can go home.